Two more Filipino boxers have qualified for the Paris Olympics. Nessy Petesho and Ira Villegas booked their spots in this year's Summer Games by advancing in their respective categories in the ongoing Olympic qualifiers in Italy. Petesho is competing in the women's featherweight division, while Villegas is in the women's light flyweight bracket. They will join fellow Filipino boxer Yumer Marshall, who had earlier secured his spot in the Paris Games. Kate, the Princess of Wales, apologizes for the confusion caused by the edited photo which her office issued Sunday. Writing on X, Kate admitted that she was responsible for editing the family photograph. Kensington Palace issued the photo of Kate and her three children Sunday, along with a message of thanks from the princess in her first public comments since undergoing abdominal surgery back in January. Several leading news organizations withdrew the photograph after post-publication analysis showed it did not meet their editorial standards. The U.S. pledges an additional $100 million for a security mission to help Haitian police fight gangs. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken announced the security aid during talks with the U.N. and Caribbean nations in Jamaica. He also unveiled $33 million in humanitarian aid. Haiti is currently under a state of emergency due to the worsening violence from gangs seeking to topple the government.
That's what brings us together today. A political crisis, escalating violence, unrest. This has created an untenable situation for the Haitian people. And we all know that urgent action is needed on both the political and security tracks to help move things in a better direction, to help do right by the people of Haiti.
This is a critical point in the history of the Caribbean. Right now, the people of Haiti are suffering.
U.S. President Joe Biden outlines his policy vision for a potential second four-year term. He unveiled a $7.3 trillion election year budget aimed at convincing Americans that he can run the economy better than Donald Trump. Biden's budget for the 2025 fiscal year, which starts this October, includes raising the corporate income tax rate from 21% to 28%, forcing those with wealth of $100 million to pay at least 25% of their income in taxes, and letting the government negotiate to bring more drug costs down. The U.S. Treasury estimates Biden's proposals would raise tax receipts by nearly $5 billion over 10 years.
The last administration enacted a $2 trillion tax cut. $2 trillion tax cut that benefits the very wealthy in the top 1%, the biggest corporations, and exploded the federal deficit. Last administration added more to the national debt than any presidential term in American history. Working people built this country. They pay more into Social Security than millionaires and billionaires do. It's not fair. Folks, we have two ways to go at Social Security and Medicare. Republicans will cut Social Security and Medicare to give us more tax cuts for the wealthy.
Congress is unlikely to adopt the measures as proposed. The Muslim holy month of Ramadan officially begins in the Philippines. To mark the event, Filipino Muslims gathered early Tuesday at the Golden Mosque to pray. Ramadan, the ninth month of the Islamic calendar, is a month-long ritual for Muslims around the world to reflect, pray, and fast as a means of spiritual discipline and strengthening their faith. Eid al-Fitr marks the end of Ramadan and is celebrated during the first 3 days of Shawwal, the 10th month of the Islamic calendar. United Nations Chief Antonio Guterres calling for a truce in the Israel-Hamas war and the conflict in Sudan as the Muslim holy month of Ramadan begins. Guterres also calling for the release of hostages held by Hamas and the removal of obstacles to ensure the delivery of aid in Gaza. The UN chief also sounding off on the further expansion of the Israeli offensive.
My strongest appeal today is to honor the spirit of Ramadan by silencing the guns and removing all obstacles to ensure the delivery of life-saving aid at the speed and massive scale required. At the same time, and in the Ramadan spirit of compassion, I call for the immediate release of all hostages. International humanitarian law lies in tatters. And the threatened Israeli assault on Rafah could plummet the people of Gaza into an even deeper circle of hell.
Israel still confirming the death of a top Hamas commander in an airstrike on an underground compound in Gaza. The Israeli ministry said, says the targeted compound was used by Marwan Issa, a deputy leader of Hamas and one of the planners of the October 7 attack that sparked the Gaza war. The military also says army forces killed a Palestinian from the occupied West Bank who was on his way to carry out a suicide attack in Israel. There has been no immediate comment from Palestinian officials on the Israeli operation. At least 50 are hurt after a Boeing 787 operated by LATAM Airlines dropped abruptly mid-flight from Sydney to Auckland. The South American carrier says the aircraft experienced a strong shake and, as a result, 10 passengers and 3 cabin crew had to be hospitalized. The cause is still being investigated. The flight with 263 passengers and 9 crew members landed in Auckland Airport as scheduled Monday afternoon. Boeing says it is working to gather more information and will provide any support to the airline.